Hello, and welcome to HealthyHouseplants.com, where we teach you all about gardening in the great indoors. Today's video is sponsored by our Amazon affiliate link, which you'll see in the description below. You'll also see in the description below any links to videos I mentioned in this video. Okay, so today's video was recommended by one of my subscribers, Christina. So thank you very much, Christina, for asking this question. It's a really good question. And that is, are coffee grounds good to use on my on the soil surface of the house plants, or even just in the soil itself? Okay, so there's a lot out there about coffee grounds, and for good reason. If you drink coffee and then you're gonna throw away the grounds, you'd like something to do with the grounds, right? I have some coffee grounds here, and they also smell pretty good. So the you can use them to a limited degree on your houseplants. I would suggest using them as a mulch, occasional mulching. I wouldn't suggest using them with every coffee that you get, then putting them on there, because first of all, you're gonna have a buildup. It's gonna get too high around your plants. But secondly, there's various problems with the coffee grounds, one of them being that after a while, when you're putting it around the top of the soil, it's going to cut off the air circulation going from the soil. And because what happens with soil and the roots, their air enters the soil up here and it goes to the roots, because roots, not only do they need moisture, they also need air. So that's why things that are packed in very heavy clay a lot of times don't survive. The roots will rot or even just die off because there's no air circulation. So you wouldn't want to pack on a whole bunch of coffee grounds on there, because the plant's not going to breathe. Another thing is it can attract fungus root gnats, because fungus root gnats love things moist, right? So all those coffee grounds on there are going to stay moist, and then the fungus root gnats are going to have a field day, because they love moist soil, or just moist organic matter in general, right? So they'll be living in that moist organic matter of the coffee grounds. Also, the coffee grounds will tend to stay moist longer than soil does, because it's denser. So if you are going to apply some, and I have some here, number one, if you grind your own beans, if you grind your beans up a little bigger, some of them a little bigger, so you don't have that really fine mix, that can be helpful. Now, there are good things about mulching plants. So this is basically your mulching plants with these coffee grounds. This is the first time, this is a croton, this is the first time I'm doing that with this, so I won't do this again until I see that the grounds have pretty much kind of composted themselves, they've broken down, they've become a part of the soil itself, and that would be the time where I would then go ahead and do this again. It also is cool because your plants, like I said, smell like coffee for a while. But you can see I put it on very loosely. However, like I mentioned, there are some good things about composting the top of your soil, the surface of your soil. First of all, the first 6 inches of your soil is where most of the biological activity is going on for your, that is of benefit to your houseplants. And you want your soil to be very biologically active, because all those beneficial organisms are going to cause a self-sustaining environment within your houseplant soil, which is then going to make sure that all the fertilizers are converted into what your plant needs, and the right ratios and that sort of thing. So the better the biology, the more alive your soil is, if you've heard about soil being alive, the more alive your soil is, the better. So some of the coffee grounds, it is an organic matter, it will give your plants more biological activity, just not overdoing it like everything, right? Also, the coffee grounds do have some nitrogen, so they are a very low source of nitrogen, which a lot of plants do like that nitrogen. They like acidic soil, so you do want to check on that too. See if your houseplant likes things on more on the acidic side. If it likes things more on the alkaline side, I would stay away from from using coffee grounds as a mulch on the plant, okay? Also, the other thing to keep in mind is, yes, as I mentioned, the coffee grounds will stay moisture, so it will act as a mulch here. I have a video on mulching as well with shredded bark, which this one had on top of it too. And what happens is that you will not have to water as frequently because it will keep moisture in the soil. As long as, like I said, it's not totally suffocating the soil. So there's a very fine line. Now, what can you do with all those extra coffee grounds? You can use them to mulch around plants outdoors. You can also, even better, and this is what I tend to do with my coffee grounds, is I put them in my compost bin, because coffee grounds are a really good source of nitrogen for your compost bin. So what you want in your compost bin is carbon to nitrogen ratio. So those coffee grounds are a really good source of the nitrogen. So I add them to my compost bin along with dried leaves at the same time, and I also put in vegetable scraps, and that's where I get the most benefit from coffee grounds. But like I said, if you're just growing indoors, it's okay to use the coffee grounds sometimes. Another thing, if you have a worm compost bin in your house, they also like the coffee grounds. It's the source of nitrogen for them that they like. So those are my top tips in terms of using coffee grounds in your house plants. Thank you for stopping by today. Please leave any comments about any indoor gardening tutorials you'd like to see. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video. And please check the bell if you'd like to be notified when we release new videos.